Morning.
So today we're going to go to Australia Zoo. I've been there a few times, but it's Mark's first time. And we're just going to stop by Zarafa's on the way to just get breakfast. And we're quite late. Who do we blame? Yep, that's right.
I have to get my makeup on.
Yeah, so we're going to stop by Zarafa's and get something to eat and drink. And then we're going to head our way to the Sunshine Coast. That's where Australia Zoo is. So we have our Zarafa's and we're just preparing to go to the motorway and then we'll start eating it. But we've got our drinks, chai latte, coca de menthe. Not sure if you can see. Oh, yep. Wait. Nope. Okay. Mountain behind the trees there. Called it Gorilla Mountain. The reason why I called it Gorilla Mountain is because it looks like a gorilla. But my best friend Claudia said that when we were little girls, that mountain actually has gorillas on there. And I believed her. But we were only like 9 years old at the time, so I like to keep that fantasy. That's an alligator, guys, not a crocodile. Still quite dangerous. How's it going?
Good. So we've seen snakes, wombats, and lizards.
Yeah.
And crocodiles. Not crocodiles.
Alligators. And where are we off to next?
Birds.
We're now heading into kangaroo heaven. Okay, just did a pee.
Kirsty's found a friend.
Hi.
this one's awake out of the many that are asleep.
Going into the Crocodile now, guys.
Catch or kill a snake. Now, Australia, we are so lucky when it comes to our snakes, as we are the only continent on Earth to have more venomous species than none. Pretty darn cool, hey? These birds, they have been seen cruising the skies of altitudes of up to 16,000 feet. 1:26 in Australia, I'd love to choose to check out any Crocodile. Is a scavenger with a preference for large carcasses like cattle and deer. They've also been seen cruising the coastline in search of beach marine mammals such as dolphins, seals, and even whales. A near threatened species, condors are still tragically being trapped, shot, and even poisoned, making them a species that is truly in need of our support. But isn't she just incredible?
But meanwhile, a 16-foot crocodile can move through knee-deep water without making a ripple. So you're sitting here fishing, and then, copy point. Shit. Hey, give me some food. Copy point. No. Isn't he cute? I think crocodiles are cute, but then again, you want to see what my wife looks extra. Wow, got me fingers in there. Isn't he awesome? You're a good dinosaur. Come on, big boy. Come on. I love that little box. Come on, big boy. The food, mate. Food. Good boy. Big hand for mother.
Is actually a natural behaviour that the crocodile has. When he pops his head just above the water like this, his eyesight is really movement orientated. You're looking at my head, mate. I know it's different.
Holy smokes! The food court. We call them chicken burgers. It's amazing what a bit of breadcrumb to do. I'm kidding.
Just looking at my head, I swear.
Oh, nice work.
So we just finished watching the crocodile show.
It was good.
Yeah. We have our lunch finally. And what we have is a teriyaki chicken sushi, tuna mayo sushi, and Mark has pulled pork sushi, pulled pork sushi with pulled pork salad. And we also have 2 apple and black currant juices.
This is going to be a disaster. Okay, guys. So we're off to see tigers and stuff.
You give her a big round of applause because it is a pretty big effort. Ready, Miki? Oh, that's cute. That is very cute, little Mika. Now this is what we call a sit-up, and Mika likes to wave when she does the sit-up sometimes too, but it's a natural behaviour that you would see tigers doing in the wild if they were to come across an overhanging branch that may have been scent marked on by another tiger. And that's because on the roof of their mouth they have a sensory organ which they use to interpret smells and pheromones left behind by other cats. And obviously being solitary animals, it's a really important way of how they communicate. And as I said, it's also a very cute little behaviour that Mika does as well. Which is okay, Charlie's what we call movement challenged. He doesn't like to move too much, and at 130 kilos, that's quite all right. But we do have another treat we can try for him in a little bit, once he wakes up a bit more. But as I mentioned before, tigers are obviously struggling in the wild, so we do thank you guys for coming along to the show and learning a little bit more about them. Hopefully you've fallen in love with them, and if you do want to help us in the fight to save them, please head on down, have a chat to Tosh. As I said, all those items he has down there do go a really long way to helping save tigers. In fact, probably the most important item he has, which I don't think I've mentioned, are these little wristbands. And they're bright orange with black stripes, and on them they say Tiger 511. Oh, there you go, Tosh is holding them up. And that stands for $5 will save one tiger in the wild for one day. Are you going to have a little play with the ball, Charlie? Maybe? He says, I'm looking at the meat on the stick. I think Elise is trying to encourage Mika to have a little jump in the pool, which she does do quite well. She's too quick for you, Elise. Charlie, they're working together here. Charlie's distracting Elise, that way Mika can get the meat. She was outsmarted. But as I said, guys, we're going to get those ropes taken down at the front, that way you can come up nice and close to the glass and check out Charlie and Mika as we get them in the water.
So where are you headed now?
We're headed to Africa.
Africa, after what?
Asia.
Southeast Asia. Africa. They're walking together. So how was Africa?
Africa was okay.
Nearly ran over someone. They're looking for a giant turtle.
You see him, Bobo?
This one came first, obviously.
This one down there is refusing to be third, and this one's okay being second. Ah, see ya. So that's an albino python. Big. Yes. So we're finished for the day.
Yep, we're on our way home now.
It's been a good day today. Saw some interesting things. What was your favourite part?
The lemur.
Me too, I like the lemurs. They were just walking around because they like to move it.
They came pretty close to people. Yeah. They're very trusting.
Yeah, they're very trusting animals. No, it was a good experience.
And the wildlife show was good.
Hmm.
Yeah, it was good.
Okay, we'll see you later. We're gonna clock off now. Bye.
Ciao.